It's official. The out-of-control Chinese space station, the Tiangong 1, crashed into Earth. I'm going to tell you everything you need to know here for you on IO. Welcome back to Inform Overload, I'm Charlotte Dobre. After 2 years of descent, the Tiangong 1 re-entered Earth's atmosphere at around 8:15 AM Beijing time on April 1st. Here's a quick refresher on this story. The Tiangong 1, aka the Heavenly Palace, was China's first space station. It was sent into orbit in 2011 by the Chinese space program. The Tiangong 1 was supposed to be brought back down to Earth, but it stopped working in March of 2016. Since then, it's been on a slow descent back down to Earth, with no real certainty about where it would crash. According to estimates, most experts believed it might crash into Barcelona, Chicago, New York, Beijing, Istanbul, Rome, or Toronto. So literally every major city in the Northern Hemisphere. According to Dr. Hugh Lewis, an expert in aerospace engineering at the University of Southampton, the spacecraft was traveling at an orbit of 43 degrees. It was descending at a rate of 6 kilometers per week. Many were pretty concerned about where the space station would land because it may have been carrying toxic chemicals, one of them being hydrazine. Hydrazine causes nerve and liver damage if you're exposed to it. If anyone ended up being hit by the space station, or if anyone was anywhere near it when it landed, the chemicals would have caused serious harm. But thankfully, estimates about its landing point were way off. Which is funny because there were a lot of places that were named as potential crash points. Really? And you didn't think like Pacific Ocean, that takes up almost half our planet, was one of the options? Really, scientists? Geez, go back to school. That being said, this was an out-of-control space station, so its landing point was difficult to predict. It re-entered Earth's atmosphere over the Pacific Ocean off the coast of Tahiti. The space station was the size of a school bus. Most of the pieces burnt up in the atmosphere, and the rest plunged into the Pacific Ocean. Some of the pieces were actually pretty big, about 100 kilograms. So needless to say, some fish probably died when it crashed. Probably. Alrighty guys, that's all I have to say about that. It's time to respond to some comments. Aaron M said, I showed IO to my teachers and all of them subscribed. By the way, I love the vids. Hey, hear that? Teachers watch IO. Take that, Mr. Katchuk. I'm still triggered about her putting me in detention in grade 7. Chris Murder said, let us see you without your hat. No. I didn't wash my hair today. Frank C said, my wife hit me in the face with a potato. You probably deserved it. Just kidding. I feel bad for you. Potatoes hurt when they hit you in the face. I should know. Because when I suck on IO, people throw potatoes at me. That is all I have for you on that. Thank you for watching. If you need a place to get your news on YouTube, IO has you covered. Don't forget to show us some love by giving us a thumbs up and subscribing. By the way, we are doing a sick giveaway right now. To find out more information, follow IO on Instagram. I'll put the link in the description. Still watching? Hey, if you love IO so much, why don't you click on this playlist over here?